It's hard. It's hard. You ever realize how hard it is to get in shape? Because everything costs money. It's expensive to get in shape. Everything costs money. Workout clothes are expensive. You guys, I went to a store called Lululemon. Now I know why they lose weight. They can't afford to buy food after they buy that shit. It's insane. If you don't know what Lululemon is, it's a store that sells workout clothes for people that don't need a workout. I went into the store, right? Guess what I found out? I'm too fat to fit into their workout clothes. I'm too fat to work out? I have to lose 20 pounds before I can start working out. But I didn't want to leave empty-handed, right? So I started looking around for anything that fit, right? I'm like, where the hell are your headbands? You don't have headbands, or you don't have wristbands, or you don't sell keychains. They don't sell keychains here. Finally, I found a sports bra that kind of fit, right? Kind of fit. Like if I light a candle and pray, like I am. I can put it on. You know, like when you try clothes on and they fit, but then you don't know how you're gonna get them off? Like, I need scissors like that, right? I looked at the price, $80. $80. I was like, $80? For $10, I can go to Home Depot and hire a day laborer to hold them up when I go jog. Andale, Pepe.
I've done pretty good during COVID. I feel like you could either, I lost some weight during COVID. You could go two ways. If you wanted to gain weight, this is your time. I mean, everybody's fine with it. You can just do it. But I've been doing all that up until COVID. I've always lived by that rule. So during COVID, I was like, I need to stop. And my neighbor started working out in his driveway. And so he was like, let's work out in my driveway. And, you know, it's hard to make a lot of excuses during COVID. You're like, I'm just so busy. You know, I got a lot of stuff to do today. And he's just out there. So I started doing it with him. And he had a trainer. And I'm not a big fan of working out. Never done it. And I told him, I was like, I just want to do upper body stuff. And they go, all right, well, how about we just do legs every day? That's all it is legs. I think it's a huge conspiracy with trainers that you never actually do your upper body. And when you are doing it, I mean, I asked him, I go, is this upper body? He goes, yeah. I go, yeah, because I'm bending down quite a bit. What I eat is, that's the main problem. I eat like a child. It's not good. He goes, let's go through like what you had for breakfast, or your whole day of eating. He goes, let's go through yesterday. And in my head, I'm like, well, yesterday's not a good day. You know, let's pick another day. He goes, go through yesterday. I go, all right, I had donuts in the morning. And he goes, all right, was it like they were just out or something? I go, no, I drove to it. I drove to it, and he's like, is it on your way? I go, nope, I was late to where I was going because of it. He goes, what about late night snacking? And I was like, well, I had Sour Patch Kids last night. He goes, did you watch a movie? I go, no, just regular TV. And ate only, he's like, the little kid bag? I go, no, it was a bag. It was a bag of them. If you saw without a label and someone said, hand me that bag, they wouldn't be confused on what you were asking. I always have trouble going to sleep, and I swear every doctor, it's like I eat Sour Patch Kids and have soda, and I'm like, what's going on, man? I can't. Dude, at night, my brain just doesn't stop. And they're like, yeah, dude, you can't eat Sour Patch Kids in bed. Maybe that's a problem.
I used to be thin when I was six. I put on some weight, but luckily this is intentional. I don't want to brag or anything, but I'm preparing for kind of a big role. It's a cinnamon roll. I don't look like I can't finish it, you know what I mean? Once after a show, a woman came up to me and she was like, "You're not that fat." Like it was a compliment. I was like, "Well, thank you. You're not that polite." But I am fat. You know, some people should be fat, you know? We all have that friend that's lost tons of weight, and whenever you see him, you always think, "You look better fat." "You're thin, but you look exhausted." "Go back to being fat. Looking at you makes me want to sit down. Nothing tastes as good as thin." I can think of 1,000 things. Even unsalted French fries taste better than thin. You ever eat fries without salt on them? You're like, "Huh, these could use some salt, but that would mean I'd have to get up and move." I'll just imagine there's salt on them. Feels like a sacrifice. You're like, "What am I, a pioneer here? Sucking it up. I should be on that show Survivor. Once I had fries without salt on them, so I'd probably live anywhere, really." I just wish I wanted to eat something healthy. Recently, I saw an apple, and for a moment, just a moment, I didn't recognize it. I was like, "What is that?" "Oh, that's an apple! So weird to not see it in a pie." But fruit, no one really wants fruit. It's too much work with fruit, right? You gotta wash it, you gotta peel off that sticker Al-Qaeda put on there. There's work! Like an orange, has peeling an orange ever really been worth it? There's not even chocolate in this.
It's the last day of my diet. I was only doing it to get in these jeans for this show, that's it. I did it, I accomplished it, I'm eating everything. Thank you. Yeah, quarantine, I gained 25 pounds during quarantine. Yeah, but I lost 18 of it back, so it's cool. I did Weight Watchers. Anybody else ever done Weight Watchers? Hey, it works. It's easy to follow, I just do the app. You know what I'm saying? I'm losing weight. I'm sleeping a lot more now that I'm on Weight Watchers. Cause when I run out of points for the day, I go to bed, that's how I do it. What I'm stay up for, I'm not gonna stay up 5 more hours and be starving, that's stupid, why would I do that? But now I'm thinking, you know what I mean? Like, what I really wanted to do, I probably should stay on it. Cause like, I had this goal of going skydiving this year. I really wanted to go. I don't know if any of you guys have ever been skydiving. I tried to go. You have, you've been? Yeah, did you like it? I don't know why I'm talking to you like I can hear you. You have on a mask. No, don't take it off. It's fine, I shouldn't have asked. Yes, you went skydiving, you probably liked it. Yeah, you liked it. I wanted to go last year for my birthday. I called to make an appointment. I was very excited. Talked to the guy. He's, you know, taking down my basic contact information. And then he asked me approximately what I weigh, and I told him. And then he said, "Well, we could let you jump," which, that's not a promising first half of a sentence, right? "We could let you jump." And then he tells me they're gonna have to add a weight surcharge to my jump fee because I'm too puffy. Yeah, and I was like, "Nah, dude, like I'm not really trying to pay a fat tax on my birthday. What's the charge for exactly?" And he says, "Well, you know, you're above the recommended weight, but you're still within the parameters, so we can let you jump. But the extra weight puts more stress on the jump instructor, which is the person on my back. So that's what the fee is for." And again, I was like, "All right, but just so we're clear, like by stress, do you mean I could physically injure this person? Or will just the thought of being strapped to me keep him up at night? Like, what kind of stress are we talking about? Like, he's so bad, I'm stressed out. Like, cause that I'm not paying for.
I started boxing. Boxing became a hobby. Reason why I started boxing, because I felt like it was something I could get better at every day. Every day I can get good. It's me against me. When I found a trainer, man, guy had amazing talent underneath his belt. Golden Glove fighters. Junior Olympics, like, I mean, it was so much, lightweight champions. I said, "Look, I know you're not working now, man, but I'll pay you good money to train me." He said, "Kevin, if you take me on, I'll make you the best fighter there was." I said, "Well, that's too much. I don't want that, I just want to get good." He said, "Done." He became my trainer, gotta be honest with you. He was fucking good, made me good. Told me shit I thought I would never hear. compared me to boxers that I never heard of, but it still was a compliment. Told me I reminded him of a fighter named Lefty Lou Earl. He said, Kevin, do you know who that is? I said, no, I do not. He said, I'm gonna bring you a tape. You got a VCR? No, no, I do not. The thing that made me laugh, when I told him I didn't have a VCR, he was like, ah. like I was in the wrong year. Can't believe you don't have a VCR, goddamn. Why do you still have a VCR, sir? Told me that I had one of the best jabs you've ever seen. Said, Kevin, your jab reminds me of lightning coming from your shoulders. Lightning coming from your fucking shoulders. He said, Kevin, you ever thought about fighting? I said, no. He said, what about sparring? I said, no, but I would. That's all I need to hear. Tomorrow, 6 a.m., I'm gonna set you up. You need to see how good you are. 6 a.m., I come to the gym. You got a guy in there my height, my build. Got my headgear, my codpiece, my mouthpiece. Puts it all on me, starts putting Vaseline all on my face and all on my headgear. I said, what's this for? He said, so the punches slide off. Well, we never talked. Okay, well, we didn't discuss that, but all right. Okay, all right, if that's what it's gonna do, then that's what it's gonna do. He gets done putting Vaseline on my face, he walks out the ring. I said, wait, you didn't do him yet. He said, he's okay, he don't need it. Huh, all right. That's weird. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna go with the flow. He said, guys, we're gonna do 3 3-minute rounds. Nobody's here to hurt anybody. Let's have a good time. Keep it loose. He yells out, take it easy on him. I assume he's talking to me. He's gotta be talking to me. I yell back, gotcha, coach. Put a confident laugh behind it. Ha ha. We get to our corners, the bell rings, ding, I come out. I just want him to see that I can fight. You can tell I can fucking fight by the way I hold my shoulders. Look how I'm moving, My feet are spaced apart. Look at my fucking foot moving. Look how I'm fucking moving, bitch. This ain't gonna be no cakewalk. Yeah. You see it. He flat-footed. Oh, he not even on the balls of his foot. I'm gonna whoop his ass. I'm getting more confidence as I move around. My coach says, Kevin, stop playing. Let your hands go. All right. Ask and you shall receive. I hope he got the Weather Channel, because this is about to be some lightning. When you throw a jab, you take a step. Take a step. Let the jab go at the same time. Turn it over. What? Every time. What? What? That's how you throw it. I take my step. I'm about to turn it over. I'm right here. Here it is. About to turn that bitch over. You better brace yourself. Here it come. Ooh, it's coming. Right here. I'm right here. But I'm about to get here. Here I am. But I'm about to fucking get right there. You better brace yourself. I'm right here. Before I did that, he hit me. I immediately lost my vision. Immediately. I went blind. Immediately. Couldn't see shit. Everything was fucking black.
Ken, I gotta get in shape. I love sports and I just, you know, that was my dream. My dream was to play professional sports. Yeah. I don't think I have to tell you people how that turned out. That didn't, but I still love it. I still love it. I love sports clothing. I love Under Armour. I told my manager, I said, hey, I wonder if we can get like an endorsement deal. Could you call Under Armour and see if, because I noticed The Rock got one. I thought maybe like we can get one. And he was like, you want me to call them? Yeah, can you give him a call? He's like, all right. And he called me back like 5 minutes later. I was like, that was fast. He's like, yeah, that was fast. I said, how did it go? He said, not good. In fact, they asked me if you wouldn't mind not wearing their clothes. Be careful with the clothes you buy when you're getting fat and then you lose weight and get, you gotta change your wardrobe accordingly. I threw on a mesh shirt for when I lost weight a long time ago and I went to work out in it. Thank God I walked by a mirror. I was like, oh, no, 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 no. I look like a bag of avocados. Took a little weight off. I gotta get more weight off. I gotta do it. Cause I was getting so big, by the way. It was taking longer in the shower. It was like washing a van, you know? I just started negotiating with myself. I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna do the front today, that's all. I can't be washing all day. I got things to do. I got errands to run. I'll get everything else tomorrow. I'm done.
I recently bought the Zumba DVDs. Now, there's a Zumba DVD set that comes with maracas. It's like the little weights, right? So you can keep the beat along with them, you know? Like, shh, 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 shh. The other day, you guys, I popped it in. Oh, I wish you had been there, man. Oh, you guys, I was killing it, you guys. Like, oh, like, shh, 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 shh. I was like sweating. I was like, oh my God, that must have been 20 minutes. 4 minutes. 4 minutes. Four. I got tired, right? I go into the kitchen and get a glass of water. There's a bag of popcorn right next to it. I'm like, oh my God, that looks so good. So I pop the bag of popcorn and I go back into the living room with my popcorn and my water and the DVD's playing. I'm like, oh my God, I'm working out. So what do? I sit down and I watch the DVD like it's a movie! Like, I love Zumba.